Hey, what's up, guys? It's Tanya, and I'm here with the wonderful and beautiful and talented Charli XCX. So for people who don't know, what does the XCX in your name stand for?
XCX was my MSN screen name when I was younger, which is really nerdy of me, I guess. And it stood for Kiss Charli Kiss. And when I first started playing my first shows, the promoter was like, what should I put on the flyer? And I was like 14 or 15. I was like, just put Charli XCX, and that it just kind of stuck from there. So
I also love that you love Spice Girls.
Yeah, they're like the ultimate babes. Love them.
Would you say they were like an inspiration to you?
Definitely.
Bit?
Growing up, like, I feel like every girl was inspired by the Spice Girls. Yeah, totally. I remember watching like the Spice movie, like Spice World, like possibly like four times in a day.
I did the same. Yeah. Which Spice Girl were you?
I really wanted to be Baby, but I never got to be her. You were obviously always Baby Spice. I would have been so jealous of you in school. Oh, you're so annoying.
So I have some rapid fire questions for you.
Okay.
Favorite artist you've worked with?
Iggy.
One thing you want your fans to know about you that they don't?
I actually have like 15 bottles of Justin Bieber perfume, which fans gave to me. They give it to me as presents on tour. Justin Bieber perfume and Pop-Tarts. So thanks, fans, for all
I mean,
that.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's great. It smells pretty good, actually. So
which one? Girlfriend?
The one, yeah, I think it's Girlfriend.
Yeah, yeah.
I think in the advert, they fly.
Oh.
Like, they fly in the advert. Justin's like, shh, and she's like,
who takes longer to get ready, you or Iggy?
I think Iggy takes longer to get ready. I'm just scruffy, you know? I'm not like as fancy as she is. Like, I didn't mean to. But, you know, she is like, I'm just like, whatever. I like go to stuff in like pajamas.
But you look so cute. I think you're kind of a fashion icon.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. That's very sweet.
You have your own like sense of style.
Thank you. And I never brush my hair. Her hair always looks amazing. I never brush my hair. So she takes longer, but for all the good reasons. I'm just lazy.
Who is your in case of emergency contact?
Oh God, I don't have one. Is that really bad? Like,
no.
Probably my mum.
Yeah.
But she's like never where I am, so she wouldn't be much use. She'd just be like worried on the end of the phone.
Your number one fashion obsession right now, like your go-to outfit?
Slip dresses and any nightwear. Like, nightwear is day wear is my favorite. So like pajamas, like dressing gowns, slippers, slip dresses, all of that is good.
Your album is coming out in October. It's called Sucker. How did you come up with that name?
The record's kind of punk inspired, so partially that name is to do with that, and
I love the
kind of like attitude that it has. It's partially, I think, a comment on like the people who always told me that I couldn't do it, like in the music industry, and also just kind of, I guess, a comment on the music industry as a whole and how the whole place is just basically like a circus. And it's kind of weird because I'm like part of it but not part of it, but I don't know, it's like a bizarre place, and so Sucker kind of ties into all of that.
Yeah, it's kind of cheeky because I know that the art is like an actual sucker.
Yeah lollipop. Yes.
Yeah. And then I also noticed on iTunes you only have two of the songs listed.
Yes.
Why is that?
Because I haven't decided the track listing yet, so I want to make sure it's perfect. So I'm just like, oh, okay, I'll just put the two that I know where they're going right now. The others will follow soon, I promise.
How far along in the process are you?
I mean, it's done. Like, the songs are done. Like, I've been working on this record for quite a long time now, so I just can't wait to put it out. I'm just mixing the last few songs. And, I mean, it's definitely October 21st. It's definitely coming out. I can't, like, wait any longer to put it out.
When you're deciding what songs go on the album and what doesn't go, is there something sometimes you're like, this might be too personal to share?
No, I mean, I never hold back when it comes to my songs. I'll always write about an experience I've had, or, you know, I'll never be afraid to be like real on a record, even though sometimes I write about complete fantasy. Like, other times it really is deeply personal to me, but I feel like it's always funny when I'm in the studio recording it just feels really intense and really, like, you know, personal, but then I forget that I'm gonna like put it on a record and lots of people are gonna hear it. So then when I think about it like that, it kind of freaks me out. But I always think that people like apply songs to their own lives, you know, so it would be cool if my songs kind of fitted into other people's situations too.
I'm one of those people.
Oh, thanks. You said you were violent and I see you trying to hide, but that ain't how I was brought up. Next, working for the money, cause it's for my mama time, and so you know you better show me somewhere.
bounce. Michelle.